Let's talk about the hormones in our body. Before we start, this is not a biology class. I'm not going to say where it is secreted, what are the overall functions or such. There are so many science videos doing that. What I'm going to do instead is talk about hormones in fitness, fat loss, and the general health context. There are so many myths floating around in this topic, so clearing some of them will help. We'll start with insulin. The notorious hormone, which most fitness influencers blame as the single reason why anyone is fat. They have taken it so far that sometimes I can literally imagine insulin flooding my system when I am eating cake. But the truth is, without insulin, we don't survive. So stop demonizing insulin. What does it actually do? It literally informs the body that energy or food is incoming and to store that in the form of glycogen and fat. When you eat enough, it tells the body to replenish the glycogen and fat stores. When you eat too much, it says, hey, we have extra energy, store it as fat. Simple. So insulin per se is not the problem. Eating too much is. It doesn't matter carbs, sugar, etc. as long as you don't eat more than your daily energy expenditure. The reason why it is produced more when you eat sugar is because simple sugar is digested very quickly and energy is available immediately. So more of it is produced. At the end of the day though, it doesn't matter if you are not diabetic. So understand this and stop worrying about insulin. Next up, thyroid. If anything, this hormone has more reasons for you to be fat or lean. The function of the thyroid hormone is to go attach to the muscle cells and burn glucose and release energy. If there is more thyroid, you are going to keep burning energy and turn into a skeleton. You might have seen some people very thin, eyes protruding, no cheeks. They just have an overactive thyroid. Even though they eat a lot, they might find it very difficult to gain weight. In most normal people, the hypothalamus pituitary thyroid axis that controls the thyroid hormone production also controls when it should be turned off. When it turns off late, after more thyroid is produced, you start looking like Skeletor. The reverse case is hypothyroidism. When too little is produced and you burn very little energy. We all know calories in, calories out. But what we don't understand is that two people with the same weight doing the same activities don't burn the same calories. Thyroid hormone directly impacts your BMR. Say one person has an overactive thyroid and another has underactive thyroid. The one with hyperactive thyroid will burn a lot more calories than the hypothyroid person. This is why people with thyroid problems so easily get fat. They need to eat way less than others or take medication. So don't judge all fat people as lazy. We have no idea what's happening inside the human body and how it affects people differently. Be compassionate. Next, let's talk about growth hormone. Growth hormone, as the name states, is responsible for growth and development of everything in the body. Your height, hair, skin, recovery are all functions of growth hormone. It is at its peak during your teens and it slowly declines in production as you get older. This is another hormone subjected to a lot of myths. Do fasting or intermittent fasting and you will flood your body with growth hormone. It will help you put on a lot of muscle or burn fat. BS. Ask for evidence when people make such claims. Evidence has been quite clear that growth hormone is not anabolic and does not help you put on a lot of muscle. Also, short-term increases in such hormones due to some activity like fasting or exercise just reflects the processes happening at that time. Like what's fueling your activity? It's just a fuel substrate mobilization response. Maybe it's complex. But just understand that increasing growth hormone through fasting doesn't mean miraculously you're going to put on a lot of muscle or burn fat. If anything, even in research where people are injected with high quantities of growth hormone, just saw increases in water weight and connective tissue weight, nothing else. So stop falling for fake gurus. The fourth hormone we are going to talk about is testosterone. How can we talk about hormones in the context of fitness and miss the king of hormones, testosterone? Strength, libido, power, confidence, building muscle, losing hair. Testosterone plays a huge role in all of this. In fact, the million-dollar question in the fitness industry is how to increase testosterone naturally. By the way, the day this video hits 10,000 likes, I will make a myth-busting video about it. So like the video, guys. Here are some interesting tidbits about testosterone. Do you know women also produce testosterone? In men, normal levels of testosterone are in between 300 to 1000 nanograms per deciliter. But in women, it's between 15 to 70. That's a stark difference. Also, do you know? Cholesterol is used to produce testosterone. The next hormone we are going to talk about is DHT or dihydrotestosterone. Have you ever wondered why a lot of men go bald but women don't? I'm not talking about hair fall. Everyone experiences hair fall. But why do only men go bald and women don't? This is the reason. DHT. An enzyme called 5-alpha reductase acts on testosterone and converts testosterone into DHT in different tissues, one being the hair follicles in your head, causing hair loss. So dear guys, check to see if your condition is androgenic alopecia or male pattern baldness, and then check to see if the solution someone is selling will help with it, because there are a number of fake hair loss treatments. This condition is also genetic. I have personally experienced this and was able to reverse it a bit, but that's for another video. By the way, causing hair loss is not the actual work of DHT. It's androgenic. It differentiates sex organs. It also plays a role in facial and body hair. It helps muscle building and has a number of uses. So don't hate this hormone because you lose hair. A number of people do this to prevent hair loss and go fall for DHT blockers. This can literally cause erectile dysfunction. Next up, estrogen, commonly called the female sex hormone, but men also have it. Just like testosterone in women, the quantities are reversed. It is also a very important hormone. It helps build muscle, increases collagen content, increases metabolism, and has anti-inflammatory properties. It increases HDL or the good cholesterol and decreases LDL, the bad cholesterol, thereby playing an important role in cardiovascular health. It also impacts fat storage and water retention. This is one of the reasons why women hold more fat than men. Everyone knows ovaries produce estrogen, but do you know in men the enzyme aromatase acts on testosterone and aromatizes it into estrogen? And where does it happen? In the adipose tissue, that is your fat. This is one of the important reasons why men should consider losing fat to improve their free testosterone levels. When you hold more body fat, the estrogen levels in your body tend to rise. Elevated estrogen levels can be the reason behind your man boobs, constantly feeling tired, and so on. It also affects your mood if estrogen levels are not in balance. This is why there are so many videos making fun of women during their period. Empathize. Also, now that you know fat converts testosterone into estrogen, instead of buying some fake testosterone booster, try losing body fat and see the difference it brings. The last hormone we are going to talk about today is leptin. Leptin is another important hormone that impacts fat loss. It is called the satiety hormone and regulates your fat storage. Leptin, along with the hunger hormone ghrelin, can be attributed to have the biggest impact on your fat gain or fat loss processes. How? Leptin levels change between lean and overweight individuals. When you continuously overeat and get obese, your brain stops responding to leptin signals and you develop something called leptin resistance. You no longer feel signals of satiety and keep overeating. One of the best ways to fix leptin resistance is by losing body fat. Losing body fat sensitizes your brain to high leptin levels and thereby overcoming leptin resistance. But when you continuously keep losing fat, your leptin levels go low. This signals the body to start using lower fat and your metabolism adapts. This is one of the reasons why you experience weight loss plateaus. So you cannot continuously keep reducing your calories and expect to lose fat all the time. It doesn't work like that. Your body has switches like leptin to turn things off and not let you starve to death soon. So make sure to replenish your leptin levels when you hit a weight loss plateau. Hope you learned a lot about the hormones influencing a number of functions in your body. If there is one takeaway from this video, it should be that all these hormones keep the body in homeostasis. So the goal should be not about increasing one or decreasing another. It should be to keep them in balance. Because impacting the balance has a whole lot of consequences, from acne and hair loss to sexual and cardiovascular health. So when you face some hormonal problem, don't buy some booster supplements. Instead, go see an urologist or an endocrinologist. Hope this helps. Thanks.